What's up, Morasokas? Hey, what's going on, man? I got some great fragrances for you guys today. These are long-lasting fragrances. These fragrances can last for hours and hours and hours. Well, they can. Anyway, listen. You guys don't want to miss this list, all right? I got some heat for you, some long-lasting fragrances. These things go for a long time. And the great thing about it is I don't really talk about these fragrances a lot on the channel, all right? So it's not ones you've heard about before in this category. Well, a few of them you might have, but you get it. I got some good ones, so let's get into it. What's going on, YouTube? I am Darren the Bowtie, fragrance guy on this channel. We talk about fashion. We talk about fragrance. We talk about lifestyle. So if that stuff is interesting to you, fashion, fragrance, lifestyle, consider subscribing to the channel. And if you do that, man, make sure you hit the bell icon as well. That way, when I upload new content, you guys don't miss out and you get notified, man. You get the information in your feed sometimes. Sometimes you don't. Sometimes YouTube does what they want to do. I don't know. You get the bell icon, you don't get the videos. We do sometimes weeks later. But anyway, I'm sorry. Another topic. So guys, you see the title, man. We're talking about 10 fragrances in my collection that are really long-lasting. These fragrances on my skin have great projection, great longevity as well. So for you guys that out there that are all concerned about fragrances that give you great performance, then this video is going to be for you today. All right? This is your video. Now, I know there's some people out there that don't really care that much about performance, but all you guys out there that really put it high on your list of priorities when you're trying to find a fragrance, I got some great ones on this list for you today. So without further ado, after the intro, when we come back, 10 fragrances that have great longevity and projection that last a long time. If you want to see what I chose, what's on the list today, you guys already know the routine. Keep it locked right here.
Fragrance guy.
All right, guys, we are back. Thank you so much for keeping it locked in. We're going to jump into the video really quick, man. I just want to say, guys, thank you so much, man. We are on the road to 100,000 subscribers. And I'm going to tell you right now, when we hit 100,000 subscribers, we're going to have a big celebration, all right? I'm going to go live. I'm going to have some special guests come through and talk on the channel, man. We're just going to have a big soiree. So get your favorite cigar ready. Get your favorite drink of choice. We're going to have a good time when we hit 100,000 subscribers. I don't know, man. Can we do it by the end of the year? Can we do it? I don't know. Can we? You guys tell me. Can we do it? Can we do it? I hope that we can. We're at about 91,000 subscribers, and I thank you guys so much. You know, when I picked up my phone and started recording videos, man, a couple years ago, didn't really have any expectations. I just knew it was something that I had a passion for and wanted to do it. And, you know, here we are. So anyway, we're going to be doing that, man. So keep your eyes open on this, eyes open and on that subscriber count. When we hit 100,000, we're going to celebrate. It would be great if we could do it by the end of the year and kind of, you know, right at the end of December, man. And then like January 1st have this big thing, man. But we'll see. Anyway, we're on the way. So thank you guys for your support. Second order of business, man. Real quick fashion tip. I love the fall, man. I love the fall for not only fragrances, but for fashion as well. I love fall for fashion because of the tones and the colors that are, I like to wear that are appropriate for the fall. Like you see the colors in this tie, it is a nice hue of brown, which is the perfect color to wear in the fall. You know, I can break out my brown ties. It has hints of blue, a little bit of tan in there as well. But this goes really, really well, the color brown, with the suit that I'm wearing today, because it has some hints of brown in here as well. But I love the fact of as well that I can pull out my heavier wool fabrics. Some of my flannel suits and things of that nature, this suit 100% wool, so a little bit more of a heavier wool. But anyway, I love fall for fashion as well as fragrance. So welcome fall. Not to mention the fact that my birthday's in fall, but we'll talk about when we get closer to November 19th. But anyway, man, let's go ahead and get into this list. All right, guys, the first fragrance up on the list that I want to talk about today on this list, this one comes from the house by Killian, and I promise you, I have to not, I don't want to say scrub off, because a lot of people use the word scrub off when they're talking about or referencing a fragrance that they don't like. I enjoy this fragrance, but I do have to scrub it off when it is time to take a shower, because that's the only way that's going to come off of my skin. Now, again, I will say this before I even get into this list. Your mileage may vary. Some of these fragrances may not quite work on your skin like they do mine. I'm just telling you what works for you, boy. But this fragrance comes from the house of By Killian, man, and this is called Back to Black. Back to Black. Man, this fragrance right here features a very, very, very animalic note of honey in the opening. And that honey sticks around for the entirety of your wearing of this fragrance. You have some honey in here, you have tobacco, you have vanilla, you have benzoin, so it's really syrupy, sexy, sultry fragrance that sticks around all day long on my skin. So if you're looking for a fragrance that has great projection, great longevity, that's gonna be there for at the end of the day, that's gonna stick it out with you, it's gonna be a ride or die on your skin, then check this one out, man. It's from the house of By Killian, and again, this is called Back to Black. All right, this next fragrance actually comes from the house of Javoy, and this fragrance is called Psychedelic. Psychedelic. Man, look at the hue and tone of this fragrance, man. That's a good indicator of what's inside this bottle. Only two accords that are notes that I really mention when I'm talking about this fragrance. If you love amber and you love patchouli, then this is one that you gotta get your nose on. Again, it's one of the best patchouli fragrances in that I have in my collection that I've put my nose on. It's more patchouli than amber, but those are the two main notes, of course, that you get in the fragrance. But my God, on my skin, this thing sticks around for a long time. I don't have to keep talking about, you know, the longevity, because you guys know that's what the fragrance, what this video is about today. Fragrances that have great performance and longevity. This is one that you might want to try if you're looking for something that's going to stick around for a long time. So check it out. It's from the house of Javoy, and this fragrance is called Psychedelic. Now, I'm going to tell you this as well, guys. All of these fragrances last at least 8 hours on my skin, and I get great projection at least 3 hours. I'm talking about projection where you don't even have to start to do this at all to pick it up. That bubble is around me for a long time. I can just be doing whatever I'm doing and still pick it up without having to, you know, really try at all. That's what I'm talking about on this list. But anyway, this next fragrance, guys, this fragrance has come into my life and it has blew my mind. A lot of people have talked very highly about this fragrance, and people whose opinion that I respect, and I have not been disappointed one bit. I could wear this fragrance every day and never get tired of it. But it comes from the house of Boadicea Victorious, and this is called Blue Sapphire. Blue Sapphire. And this is another fragrance that sticks around all day, man. All day. Just to simplify it, because I am going to do a full review, that is, there is this combination of citruses and florals in the opening that is almost, it's sweet, it's almost a candy-like kind of sweetness in the opening of the fragrance. And then, of course, you got the rose and the oud. A little bit of spiciness in this one as well. It's good, man. That's all I can say. It's good, and it lasts a long time. And when a fragrance smells this good, you certainly don't mind the fragrance lasting and sticking around so long. So get a sample of this, guys. I know it's an expensive fragrance, but get a sample of it, guys. You don't have to buy full bottles of stuff. I buy the bottles for you guys, so you guys, I can tell you about it. That way, you know, if you trust my opinion, and you can go out there and just sample it. But anyway, check this one out. It's from the house of Boadicea the Victorious, and this one is called Blue Sapphire. All right, guys, this next fragrance on the list is another one. Again, I told you guys I'm going to talk about some stuff that not a lot of people talk about. This one comes from the house of Parfum Aroma, and this is called Ombre Ardua. And this is a pure amber fragrance. A pure amber fragrance. This is an amber bomb. So if you love amber, you're going to love this fragrance. That's really the only note that's or chord that I really need to talk about, because it's all about amber. I mean, 100% about amber. So if you don't like amber, don't get this fragrance. But if you do love amber, you'll be in heaven. I mean, guys, again, this is one. Just look at the color of the juice, man. Look at this. My gosh, this is good. And with these fragrances from this house, they have a very high level of oil concentration. This is the only fragrance brand that I'm aware of that really recommends you rub it a little bit, because it has such a high oil content. But it's going to stick around all day. And I mean all day. So check it out. It's from the house of Parfum Aroma. This is Ombre Aria. All right, guys. This next fragrance actually was a more recognizable or more talked about or discussed fragrance here. But on my skin, it gets amazing performance. And it's from the house of Nishane. And this one is called Ani. This is called Ani. I really enjoy this one as well, man. Again, this, to me, more than anything, to my nose, is about the vanilla in this fragrance. The vanilla-benzoin combination kind of creates an ambery kind of feel in this fragrance when it dries down. But when it opens up, man, you get this, you know, just this host of fresh spiciness. You got some ginger in here. You have some pink pepper in this as well. And, yeah, a little bit of rose in the heart. But again, to me, this is really about the vanilla. I get a very strong vanillic overtone in this fragrance. And again, it lasts for a long time. Most of the fragrances I actually have from Nishane do really well in the performance category. And this is one that's at the top of the list when we talk about overall performance. So check it out, guys. It's from the house of Nishane. And again, this is called Ani. All right, guys, the next fragrance on this list, I'm just noticing this, guys. I have three fragrances in a row here that are done by the same perfumer, which is Cécile Zarokin. She does a great job in this space. These really spicy, ambery fragrances is kind of what she does really, really well. But Ani, Nishane Ani, was done by Cécile Zarokin. And also this fragrance from the house of Mass Milano. This is called Tango. Tango. Another one, man. If you look at the color of the juice, man, it's going to kind of tell you what's going on in here. And if you thought about this, then you are correct. Yes, this has a very prominent amber accord in this one as well. So you get the amber in here. You get the some benzoin in this one as well. And again, what Cécile Zarokin, in my opinion, does well. These very spicy, ambery kind of fragrances, and that's exactly what this is. And that's why I noticed that as of late here, I started to really gravitate towards fragrances with amber, because they just do well on my skin, especially when the weather starts to cool down, which now, of course, we're in the heart of the fall season. These are the kind of fragrances that, you know, give me that warmth when I go outside when it's cold, and I love that this time of the year. But this is a really, really good one, man, that has great performance on my skin. It's from the house of Mask Milano. This one is called Tango. All right, guys, this is the third fragrance in a row that is actually done by Cécile Zarokin. And this is one of the newest ones from the Opus Library collection of from the house of Amouage. And this is called Royal Tobacco. Royal Tobacco. Love the bottle, man. It's kind of ceramic feel. To the bottle with the gray, light gray, dark gray hues on the bottle cap. Man, this stuff is good. Now, I will tell you, man, this is not going to be for everybody. If you don't like this almost this really green fragrance, almost coniferous kind of smell in the opening, then this is not going to be your thing, because this fragrance is really, really green in the opening, man. Again, you get almost this vibe as if you're walking in a forest and all the ferns and the greenness, the pine needles. Like, you kind of get that vibe really strong in the opening of this fragrance. It is smoky, very smoky, leathery nuances to this fragrance as well with the tobacco. But again, magnificent fragrance. And it lasts all freaking day on my skin. You don't need a lot. A little goes a long way with this fragrance. But anyway, if that's your kind of vibe, you like really green, spicy, coniferous, you know, fern-like scent DNAs with some tobacco and incense-y smokiness, you're going to love this fragrance. So check it out. It's from the House of Armoires. Again, this is called Royal Tobacco. All right, guys, the next fragrance on this list, oh my gosh, this stuff is so good, man. This is so good. If you love gourmand fragrances, I think this is one that you are going to really enjoy. It's absolutely fantastic. It comes from the House of Unique Luxury, and this is called Crush On Me. Crush On Me. Amazing presentation as well on this bottle. I mean, just take a look at it, guys. Look at the cap on this thing. Amazing fragrance. Again, it's for the gourmand lovers out there. And of course, as I said before, this thing lasts all day long. I will tell you now, this is one that you don't want. It doesn't look that dark as far as the overall color, but you don't want to spray your clothes with this one as well, because it could stain. But listen, caramel and patchouli. Now, you do have a little bit of spiciness that comes from ginger in here that keeps it from being overly sweet and too syrupy, if that makes sense. But man, this stuff smells absolutely amazing. You've heard me say it before, you've heard it before, smelling like a snack. This is gonna have you smelling like a snack, for sure. And smelling that way for a long time. It's from the House of Unique Luxury. And again, this one is called Crush On Me. All right, guys, another fragrance that I've talked about a lot is moving into my top 10 fragrances in my entire collection. So I won't spend too much time on it, but it's from the House of Tom Ford. This is Tobacco Oud. Tobacco Oud. And this is just my thing, man. It's my jam. It's everything that I love in a fragrance. It has that you know, kind of sexy, kind of sophisticated feel that a fragrance has when it's really boozy. You got this whiskey accord in here. You have some amber. You have some sweetness in it. Again, for me, everything that I love in a fragrance, it's all in this bottle, man. So sad that this fragrance was discontinued. Maybe he'll bring it back one day, I don't know. But Tom Ford, you need to, because this is an absolute masterfully done fragrance that lasts all day long on my skin. So check it out, from the House of Tom Ford. Again, this one is called Tobacco Oud. All right, guys, next up on this list of fragrances that have great performance, longevity, this one comes from the House of Parfums de Marly, and this one is Carlisle. Carlisle, Carlisle, Carlisle. And I don't know, sometimes when I do my top 10 fragrances for life, sometimes, man, I just have newer things in my collection that gets more of my attention. But when I go back to this fragrance, again, it has vibes of Leighton, has similarities to Herod. Just a lot of the most recognizable fragrances from the brand of Parfums de Marly. I just feel like they took all of the goodness from all of the best fragrances and kind of put it in this bottle, and that is Carlisle. The green apple in here, of course, is going to give you remind you of Leighton. The sweetness in here is going to kind of remind you of Wajian. I mean, again, all the great ones, it smells like they put it all in one bottle. And this stuff is amazing. Patchouli, vanilla, tonka. I love this stuff. Rose. Get it. If you don't have it, get it, guys. And it lasts a long time on my skin. From the House of Parfums de Marly. You can't go wrong with this one, man. It's called Carlisle. But that is it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video today, as I gave you 10 fragrances in my collection that have amazing performance, great longevity on my skin. As always, I sincerely appreciate your time. I appreciate your attention to these videos. I know you guys don't have to watch, but you do, and I sincerely appreciate that. Now, guys, we are on the road to 100K, so help me get there. If there's anybody out there that you know that could benefit from this content or may like it, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. As always, I sincerely appreciate you guys. And as always, I will catch you.